IBPS clerk prelims. Let's start from arithmetic section, question number 31. So from question number 31 onwards, we have arithmetic question. So we'll write it in index. Till how many questions we have arithmetic? Yes. So till 36 we have arithmetic questions. From 37 onwards, because these are numerical ability questions, we can directly start them. When you have continuous division, first number comes in numerator, remaining numbers comes in denominator. So we know that these two numbers comes in denominator. This number is having one digit after decimal, and here also we have one digit after decimal. So directly we can start writing this as 11,725 divided by 134 into 0.25. 0.25 meaning 1 by 4. Denominator in denominator comes to numerator. So now, instead of going for entire simplification, it is better to verify the last digit. 2, 6 times, and then 7 times. 2, 2 times. 2 multiplied by 5 will give you 1 0. In denominator, we don't have 5 multiple. So definitely there must be 1 0. Let me separate that 5 here. 5 into 2 times 17 we have, 3 times 22 we have, 4 times, and then again 5 times. 5 into 2, that is 0. Apart from that, we have a number which is a 5 multiple divided by 7. So answer will be definitely ends with 5. This cannot be your answer, this cannot be your answer. 0 and then 5 must be there, either 350 or 150. If it has to be 150, the number should be a 3 multiple. Just observe whether we have any 3 multiple in 2, 3, 4, 5. No. When 2, 3, 4, 5 is not a 3 multiple, there is no possibility of getting 150, hence answer is 350. Next. Divided by 8 is equal to 216 to the power of 1 by 3. 216 can be written as 6 cube to the power of 1 by 3, that is 6. 8 goes to other side, that is equal to 6 into 8, 48. But we have under root 12. Squaring on both sides, this gives you x plus 1304. 48 square, which is 2 less than 50. 2 square is equal to 04. 2 subtracted from 25, that is equal to 23. Then x is equal to 2304 minus 1304. Answer is 1000. Second option. 8 cube, that is equal to 512. If you add this 0.75 to this number, it becomes 625 and it becomes 655. 600, 600, 1200 and then 80. 1280 we have. Out of 1280, what percentage is equal to 512? 10 percentage is 128, double 256, double 512. 10% double, 20% double, 40% first option answer. Minus 608 goes to the other side, becomes plus 608. The total value becomes 1044. Out of 1450, what percentage is equal to 1040? 50% is equal to 725. This is much more than that. Hence, answer should be definitely more than 50. It is not even nearby 50. So this is eliminated. This is eliminated. Either it is 63% or 72%. 50% of this number is 725. 25% is equal to 312 point something. So 1000 plus we have, hence answer should be close to 75% only. Third option is our final answer. Now 696 we have. To make it round figure, we need 4. Take 4 from this number. This is 744. 744. From this, if you subtract 374 minus 374. 4 minus 4, 0. 74 minus 37, that is equal to 370. Is equal to 18.5 into how much? then x value is equal to 370 divided by 18.5. 10 times of denominator is 185, exactly double, that is 370. 10 times double in the sense 20 times. First option answer. 9 square into 14 square. Let us write it as it is. 9 square into 14 square divided by 2401. That is equal to 49 square. Square and under root gets cancelled. You'll have 49. Instead of 49, we can even write it as 7 square. 7 square in 14 square gets cancelled and finally we will have 2 square. 9 square into 2 square in the sense that is 18 square, that is equal to 324. 324, right hand side number we have 117. If that comes to left hand side becomes positive number, which is equal to 441. 441 is equal to x square, then x is equal to 21. Fifth option is our answer. Now, 13 by 16 minus 8 5 by 8. 12 minus 8 4. 13 by 16 minus 5 by 8. 5 by 8 can be written as 10 by 8 also. 10 by 16. 13 by 16 minus 10 by 16, that is equal to 3 by 16. Of x is equal to 833. 4 into 16, 64, plus 3, 67 by 16. Then x is equal to 833 into 16 divided by 67. 67, once 67 we have. And apart from that, we have 163. 163 in the sense, approximately 2 times. Or you can even treat it as 13 times also. 13 into 16. 16, 10 times 160, 16, 3 is 48. Answer 208. Answer should be close to that. Fifth option is our final answer. 1331 plus 7 divided by 0.02. That means under root of 1331 plus 7 divided by 2 by 100 you can write. 2 by 100 divided by 2 by 100 can be written as into 100 by 2. 2 50 times here. 50 into 7, 350. To this, if you add 350, that will have under root 1681. 40 square is 1600. This is equal to 41 square. Fourth option, final answer. Under root 5184. 70 square is equal to 4900. This is more than that. Because this is ending with 4, that may be either 72 square or 78 square. 2 square ends with 4, 8 square also ends with 4. This is close to 4900, so this cannot be 78, it has to be 72 only. 72 divided by 6 by 5 whole square can be written as into 5 by 6 whole square. 5 square by 6 square, that is equal to 36. Is equal to x into 25. 5 square, 25 gets cancelled. 36 2 times here. X is equal to 2, second option. Take 643 to right hand side. That will give you 2831 minus 643. Approximately, if you subtract 700, that will be 2131 plus 50, that is approximately 2180. Approximate value. 1641 divided by x is equal to this one. 1641 by x is equal to this much. Then x is equal to 1641 divided by 2180. 10% is equal to 218. Approximately 75% we have. 75% in the sense 0.75. 0.75, that is equal to third option. Half of this number is 1019. Again, half is equal to 545. Total 1635. Your numerator is approximate to that. This is 50% and this is equal to 25%. Then sum is equal to 75%. 75% is equal to 0.75, third option. Now these are number series questions. We'll continue solving this because these are just number series only, not wrong number series. So how many such questions are there? Yes, till 51 we have. From 52, yes, this is a data analysis and a simple table. Definitely we can start answering these questions. You don't have to skip these questions because all are two digit numbers only and clear data we have. This table shows the number of people who watched four different movies WXYZ during 5 days, Monday to Friday of a particular week. In a particular week, what was the difference between total number of people who watched movies X, Y together on Wednesday? Wednesday, X and Y, sum of both values, that is equal to 93. You're asked to calculate difference between this number and those who watch the same movies together on Friday. Same movies on Friday. On Friday, we have 26 and 40, 66 differences. Subtract 70, add 4. When you subtract 70, you'll have 23 plus 4, 27. 27, third option answer. Number of people who watched movie Z on Friday. Movie Z on Friday, 72, was approximately what percent of those who watched the same movie on Wednesday? Same movie on Wednesday, that is 56. So now we have to calculate 72 is what percentage of 56, that is percentage into 100. 8, 9 times here, and this is 7 times. 9 by 7 in the sense 1, 2 by 7. 1 in the sense 100 percentage. 2 by 7 in the sense 2 times of 14, 2 by 7. That is equal to 28, 4 by 7 percentage. 128 percentage approximate, which is fifth option. What was the respective ratio between total number of people who watched movie W on Tuesday and Thursday? W on Tuesday and Thursday. That is equal to 42. As it is, ratio A is to B or A by B form. And those who watched movie Y on same days together. Y on same days together, 51 and 45, that is equal to 96. Cancellation with 6, 7 times, 6, 16 times. 7 by 16, fifth option answer. If the number of people who watched movie Z on Saturday, we don't have data, but they're talking about that, was 17 more than those who watched the same movie on Tuesday. Movie Z on Tuesday, 57 people watched, but on Saturday, 17 more than this number, that is equal to 57 plus 17, 74. What was the total number of people who watched movie Z on Saturday? Yes, 74, fifth option. What was the average number of people who watched movies W, Y, Z on Monday? Monday, W, Y, and Z. For these three numbers, we have to calculate average. 50, 50, 100, 110, 117. Average divided by 3. 3, 3 is 9, 27, we have 9 times. 39 is our average, which is third option. Yes, now we have Q1 and Q2s. But almost, this is not lengthy problem. 57. 58, we have one number given. 59 also, we have one number given. So definitely we can try these questions. You don't have to skip them. Average of N1, N2, N3 is 1 less than N2, N3, N4. N2, N3, N2, N3, they are quite common. So with N1, average is 1 less. That means N4 is bigger number. Now difference in their average. With N1, it is 1 less than average with N4. There are three members here. If average is 1 less, total will be 1 into 3 less. Whatever difference that we have here, that will be in between N4 and N1 only. N4 and N1 difference is equal to 1 into 3, that is 3. Because average difference is 1, then the total difference will be 1 into number of numbers, that is 1 into 3. The average of n1 and n4 is 19.5. Then sum of both the numbers is n4 plus n1, that is equal to 19.5 two times, which is 39. Then n4 is equal to sum divided by 2, 42 divided by 2, 21. N1 is equal to subtract 3 from this number, that is equal to 18. Now Q1 is 250% of this number, 200% is 36. Plus 50%, that is 9, which is equal to 45. Q2 is N4 plus 27, 21 plus 27, that is equal to 48. Q1 was 45, Q2 48, Q1 less than Q2. Next, train A traveling towards north direction at 72 km per hour crosses train B from the moment they meet, traveling towards the south direction. So one is moving towards north, the other is moving towards south. So both are moving opposite to each other. At 108 km per hour in 12 seconds, the length of train B is twice that of length of train A. Train A length is A, then train B length is 2 times of A, that is equal to 2A. If a train crosses another train, distance covered is train length 1 plus train length 2, which is equal to speed into time. Because both are moving opposite to each other, relative speed is S1 plus S2, that is 180 km per hour, 180 km per hour, convert into meter per second, 5 by 18. This is speed. And in how much time they crossed each other? 12 seconds. That means speed into time. 18, 10 times here, 5 into 12, 60 into 10, 600. 3A is equal to 600, then A is equal to divided by 3, which is equal to 200. Then train length B is equal to 2 times of which is equal to 400. Now what exactly is your question? The difference between length of both the trains, difference between train lengths is equal to 200. Q1 is 200, Q2 is 150. Q1 more than Q2. The amount received after 2 years on X rupees from scheme A offering compound interest at 20% per annum compounded annually was again invested after adding 480 rupees in scheme B, which is offering simple interest at 10% per annum for 2 years. The interest received from scheme B was 2400. Now, in scheme A, let us assume we invested 100%. For 2 years at 20% per annum, compound interest is 44%. So, amount received is going to be 144%. Now, in scheme B, the total amount received and along with adding 480 rupees, extra 480 rupees added, was invested in scheme B, and from scheme B, which is offering simple interest at 10% per annum for 2 years, interest received from scheme B is 2400. See, if the interest received in scheme B is 20%, which is equal to 2400. To get principal in that case, we have to multiply that with 5. 2400 5 times is equal to 12,000. So 144% plus 480 is equal to 12,000. Then only 10% is equal to 1200, 20% is equal to 2400. From this, 144% is equal to 480 goes to the other side, 11,520. And we need to calculate 100%, which is principal in scheme A. Rupees X, that's what we have to calculate. And Q2 already we have 4,000. Definitely 100% is more than 4,000. Suppose if it is 4,000, 150% is going to be 6,000. This is much more than that. So this value, X value is more than 4,000 can be concluded. It may be any number. You are not asked to calculate exact value. If you are asked to calculate exact value, 144, 8 times is 1152. And then we have a 0. So that means 80 times. 180 times, that is equal to 8,000. This is exact value. But you don't have to waste your time in getting this number. If 144% is 11,520, 100% will be definitely more than 4,000. So hence Q1 is more than Q2 can be concluded. Now in a month, out of His monthly income, Harshad spends 3,500 on bill. 3,500 on bill and 8,000 rupees on rent amount. And deposited the remaining in a bank. The amount he deposited in the bank in a year. Be careful. So far they are talking about monthly and now they are talking about yearly. Was 2,04,000 more than that spent on bills and then rent. If 2,04,000 is for year, then per month that has to be divided by 12. 12 once, 7 times and then 3 zeros. So in bank, he is going to deposit 17,000 more than this number. Because this 2,04,000 is amount he deposited in the bank in a year was 2,04,000 more than per year, that is 2,04,000 more, then per month that has to be 17,000 more. 17,000 more than these two numbers only. 17,000 plus 3,000, 20,000, 28,500. 28,500 is deposited in the bank. 5 times of the amount spent by Harshad on rent in a month. So Q1 is equal to 5 times of the rent, which is equal to 40,000. Harshad monthly income, that's what we have to calculate, and that is equal to Q2. Sum of these two numbers is 11,500 plus 28,500, which is also equal to 40,000. Q1 and Q2 both are equal. Q1 is equal to Q2, first option answer. Now here also Q2 is mentioned. Inlet A can fill a tank in 36 hours. There was a leak in the tank due to which A could fill only 1/6 of the tank in 9 hours. If 1/6 of the tank is filled in 9 hours, total tank can be filled in 6 into 9, that is equal to 54 hours. Otherwise, if A can fill the total tank in 36 hours, 1 hour work is equal to 1/36. And including leakage, as 1/6 is filled in, 1/6 of the tank empty in 9 hours. There was a leak in the tank due to which A could fill only 1/6 of the empty tank in 9 hours. So when both are included, 6 into 9, 54 hours it is taking. So 1 hour work is equal to 1/54. This is having inlet work and outlet work. From this, if you subtract inlet work, you'll get outlet work, which is equal to, you can take 9 common. If you take 9 common from both the numbers, there will be 1/6 minus 1/4. LCM is equal to 12. 6 2 times and 4 3 times. 2 minus 3, that is minus 1. And why are we getting minus? That is because this is outlet work. If outlet work is equal to 1/B, which is equal to 1/9 into 12, 108, then B is equal to 108 hours. So outlet can empty the full tank in 108 hours. The time taken by the leak to empty the full tank when A is closed is, yes, outlet can empty the full tank in 108 hours. Q1 108, Q2 110. Q1 less than Q2. Now 62, we have again data analysis in a pie chart. Distribution of total number of students, male, female, studying tuitions for 5 subjects, English, Maths, Physics, Geography, Sanskrit, in a tuition center in June 2020. Total number is 300. So as the total number is 300 and all the values are given in percentage, 1% is equal to 3. So whenever you want to convert percentage to number, just multiply it by 3. The respective ratio between number of female and the male studying physics is 11:7. What is the number of male studying in physics? Number of male studying in physics is 7 parts. Answer should be 7 multiple or that. All are 7 multiple. So 7 out of 11 plus 7, that is equal to 18 parts. Among physics, physics is 24%, where 1% is equal to 3. 3 6 times here, 6 4 times here. 7 into 4, 28. Third option answer. What is the central angle? Whenever they are talking about central angle, answer must be a multiple of 9. First option is not 9 multiple. Second is not 9 multiple. Third is not 9 multiple. Fourth is 9 multiple. That may be your answer. Hold it. Fifth is not 9 multiple. There is only one 9 multiple available. Fourth option, final answer. In July 2020, all the values are June 2020. Now they are talking about July 2020. The total number of students studying all the given subjects together increased by 20% as compared to the previous month. Previous month we have 300. If that value increased by 20%, 300 plus 60, that becomes 360. What is the total number of students studying all the given subjects together in July 2020? Simply that is 360. 360, first option answer. Out of the number of students studying Sanskrit, 35% are female. What is the number of male studying Sanskrit? So if 35% are female, 65% are male only. 65% of what? People who study Sanskrit. Sanskrit we have 20%, that is 20 into 1% value, that is equal to 3. 20, 5 times 5, 13 times, 13 3 is 39. Third option is our answer. So now we are left with only questions from 31 to 36, which are arithmetic questions. Now let us also complete 31 to 36 questions. In an office, 25% employees are female. So if female employees are 25%, male employees must be remaining 75%. 68% of all the male employees are science graduates. Now they are talking about science graduates. 68% of male graduates. 68% of 75 or 75% of 68 also. Getting 75% is easy to calculate. So out of 68, if you want to calculate 75%, half plus half of this number is 34, again half is 17. Total it is equal to 51. So here we have 51. And at the same time, the number of science graduate employees is 71% of total number of employees. Out of total employees, that is 100%, total science graduates are 71%. Out of 71%, there will be male and female combination. Out of 71, male are 51, then remaining 20 are female only. What percent of female employees are science graduates? So science graduate female are 20, calculated upon female total 25% into 100. 25, 4 times 20 into 4, 80%, second option. The total price of 4 sanitizers and 2 masks is equal to 1400. Total price of 3 sanitizers and 4 masks is equal to 1500. What is the total price of 3 masks? See, when you're expecting mask price, we need to eliminate sanitizers. Here we have 4 sanitizers and here we have 3 sanitizers. Let's multiply first one with 3 and the second one with 4. 3 into 4, that is 12 sanitizers, and 3 into 2 mask, that is 6 mask, is equal to 1400 3 times, which is equal to 4200. Second equation must be multiplied by 4. 3 sanitizers into 4, that is equal to 12 sanitizers, and 4 into 4, 16 mask, is equal to 1500 4 times, that is equal to 6000. Subtract first equation from the second equation, this gets cancelled. Then 10 mask price is equal to 6000 minus 4200, which is equal to 1800. 0 gets mask cancelled. One mask price is 180 and we were asked to calculate 3 mask price. 3 masks cost is equal to 3 times of 180. Answer 540, fifth option. The compound interest on 6400 for 2 years at R% per annum is 2816. Had the rate of interest been R minus 5% per annum, what would have been the compound interest on the same sum of money for the same period, that is 2 years? Sum is principally same, time period is same, but what exactly is the difference? Rate of interest. Earlier that was r percent, but now it is r minus 5. So for 1 year, it decreased by 5%. For 2 years, approximately 10% will decrease. Approximately 10%. Earlier, our interest was 2816. If rate of interest becomes r minus 5%, per year decreases by 5%. For 2 years, approximately 10%. Approximately 10% is 640. If you subtract 640, answer will be 2170 somewhere. Approximate to that number. Answer should be approximate to that. 2100. Answer should be close to that. There is only one. 2064 should be our final answer. If you want to calculate exact value, we need to identify 2816 is what percentage of 6400 percentage into 100. Two zeros gets cancelled. 64 double 128. 128 double 256. If you subtract 256 from 281, 25 and then 6. Again 256. That is 44 we have. So for 2 years, if the compound interest is equal to 44%, for 1 year, that will be equal to 20% only. Then only compound interest for 2 years becomes 44. X percent plus X square by 100. 20 plus 20, 40. 20 square by 100. 400 by 100. 4. 44. Now this ratio, rate of interest decreased by 5%. Then new rate of interest becomes 20 minus 5. That is equal to 15%. What is 15% of this number? 960. Second year also we will get 960 plus 15% of first year interest. That is 960. 96 is 10%. 48 is 5%. Now total 6 plus 8, 14, 1 carry. 9 plus 1, 10. 6 plus 4, 10. And then 6, 26. 6 we have. 9 plus 9, 18 plus 2, 20. 2064 is our final answer. But we don't have to do that. Directly we can answer it. The average of three numbers is 160. The first number is 7/13 of the second number. Denominator we have 13, that is equal to second number. So if the second number is equal to 13 parts, first number is equal to 7 parts. And the third number is 12 by 13 times of the second number. 12 by 13 times of this number is equal to 12 parts. What is the sum of first number and the third number? Sum of first and third is equal to 19 parts. Getting 19 multiple is a bit tough task. So I'd like to complete the question. Average is equal to 160. Then sum is equal to 160 into 3. That is equal to 480. So 480 is equal to how many parts? 7 plus 13, 20. 20 plus 12, 32. Now we were asked to calculate sum of first and third. Sum of first number and third number is equal to 19 parts. That means into 19. 32 exactly 15 times. 19 15 times. 10 times plus 5 times. That is equal to 285. 285, fourth option is our answer. Population of village X is 25% more than population of village Y. So if Y population was 100%, X population 25% more, that is 125%. Population of Z is 45% less than population of X. If it is 45% less, that will be 55% of population of village X, that was 125. So how do you get 55%? 50% plus 5%. 50% of this number, 62.5. 5% 6.25, then total 68.75%. So Z value is equal to 68.75%. Next, if the difference between population of village Y and Z is 1710, so difference is equal to 31.25. 31.25, I'll write it as 31 1 by 4. The same is equal to 125 by 4, which is equal to 1710. then 1% is equal to divided by 125 by 4 comes to numerator. This is 1% value. What is population of x? X population 125%, that is into 125. Both gets cancelled. We have a 0, we'll get 0. 1 into 4. Answer should end with 40. There is only one option which is ending with 40. 6840 is our final answer. 65 people attended a concert. Tickets for children were sold for 24 rupees each. And tickets for adult were sold 56 rupees. So from one child, we will charge 24. And from one adult, we will charge 56 each. Rupees 2872 was collected in tickets money. What is the difference between number of children and number of adult who have attended the concert? So out of 65 people, if you know how many are adult, we can calculate children. Or if you know how many children are there, we can even calculate adult. Once if you get how many adult and how many children are there, we can identify the difference. So for that, let us go for reverse method and assume I want to calculate how many adult are there. Let us assume adults are not there. If all are children, if all 65 people are children, how much amount would be collected? 65, 24 times. 65 20s, 1300. 65 4 times, 260. That is 1560 amount is collected. But number given in question is amount mentioned as 2872, but we have only 1560. How much less we got? We got 1312 less. What exactly is the reason for getting 1312 less? Because there are few adult, but now we converted them to children. So instead of giving 56 rupees, we are giving only 24 rupees. How much less? How much value decreased here? 32. For 1%, amount decreases by 32. And if amount decreases by this much, how many adults were converted? 1312 divided by 32. 4 times of 32, 128. And then we have 32, that is 1. So number of adults are 41 out of 65. Then remaining 24 are children. We were asked to calculate difference between both the numbers. Difference between number of adult and children, which is equal to 17. 17 is our final answer, which is fourth option. Now with this, we completed all the questions with a strategy. We'll meet in next session with a strategy. Thank you.